Good morning to everybody. Today's class is advantages and disadvantages of saturated, unsaturated and trans fat inputs. Before going to the topic, please you should know about the what are the fatty acids and functions. Now see, the fatty acids are a simple form of lipids. They contain the carboxylic acids with the hydrocarbon side chains. So these are mainly occurs in two ways, two forms, that is unsaturated, unesterified form and esterified form. So available in two forms, that is esterified form and unesterified form. So these are the carboxylic acid with the hydrocarbon side chains. So most, these are the simplest form of lipids. So most of the fatty acids occurs in natural lipids are even carbon numbers only. So the natural lipids containing the even number carbon containing fatty acids. So natural lipids containing the even carbon number containing fatty acids. The synthesis of fatty acids mainly occurs with the sequential addition of two carbon units. So the synthesis occurs mainly in the addition of every two carbon units. Addition of every two carbon units. That is example, palmitic acid, stearic acid. So here it is the sequential addition, 16 carbons. Next, add the two carbons, it is considered as a stearic acid. Next is two carbons, that is a 20 carbons containing fatty acid. Next is two carbons is, so 22 carbons containing fatty acids. And also odd chain fatty acids also synthesis, that is example, propionic acid and valeric acid. The propionic acid containing the 3 carbons, valeric acid containing the 5 carbons. So fatty acids are soluble in water, soluble in organic compounds, that is alcohol, ether and chloroform, insoluble in water. So soluble in organic compounds such as alcohol, ether and chloroform, insoluble in water. So the basic use of fats and oils to the cookery, it's add the richness and flavor to the food. So when you are using fat and oils to cooking, to add the richness and flavor to the foods. Not only the flavor to the foods, and also increase the structure of cakes, pastries and biscuits. And also increase the structure of cakes, pastries and biscuits. So plants, animals and marine foods containing the fat and oil sources. So plants, animals and marine foods, these are the sources of fat and oils. So here it is once again is a carboxylic acid and hydrocarbon side chains. They are simple form of lipids. They are available in two forms, that is esterified form and unesterified form. So most of the natural lipids containing the even number containing carbon fatty acids. So the synthesis of is mainly addition of sequential addition of two carbons, that is example is palmitic acid and stearic acid. And stearic acid. They improve the structure of cakes, pastries and biscuits. The mainly the fat and oils are found in plants, animals and marine foods. If you see the composition of the fatty acids, that is carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. So provide the more energy rather than to the carbohydrates. Now see the functions of the lipids. The main functions of the lipid is a fuel resource of the body. Example is triglyceride. And main sources are fat soluble vitamins. And maintain the regulate the cellular metabolism and serve as a insulating materials and give the shape and smooth appearance to the body, protect the internal organs, and these are constituents of membrane structure and regulate the membrane permeability. As regulate the membrane permeability, fuel resources of the body. So there's main sources for the fat soluble vitamins and regulates the cellular metabolism. Serve as the insulating materials, give the shape and smooth appearance to the body and protect the internal organs. These are the main functions of the lipids. Now see the healthy lipids. Fatty acids, fats, oils, phospholipids, lipoproteins and sterols are healthy lipids. Fatty acids, fats, oils, phospholipids, lipoproteins, sterols are the healthy lipids. Now see the numbering of the carbon atoms. The numbering of the carbon atoms in two ways. The numbering of the carbon atoms in two ways. See the fatty acid structure. So fatty acid contain the carboxylic acid group and methyl group at the terminal carbon. See, this is the terminal carbon containing the methyl group. Here it is a carboxylic acid group. This is the hydroxy side chains. So the numbering of the carbon atoms in two ways, that is numerical way, another way is omega way. So omega counting. So first one is a numerical way counting. Another counting is omega carbon counting. See here it is the numbering of the carbon atoms starts from the carboxylic carbon. Starts from the carboxylic carbon, which is taken as a number one. This is one is a this is a carboxylic carbon which is taken as a number one. This carbon is number one. The adjacent carbon is number two. Another adjacent carbon is number three. The next one is carbon four is like this. The another way is omega carbon counting. That is the terminal carbon of fatty acids containing the methyl group. So that the terminal carbon counting as a omega one, omega two, omega three, omega four, omega five like that. So the numbering of the carbon atoms in the two ways. One is in numerical formula. Another one is a omega form. So how can you identify the this is the omega 3 omega 6 when you seeing the structure of fatty acids? So when you seeing the structure of fatty acids, how can you identify this is a omega 3 fatty acid, this is a omega 6 fatty acid? So already I told you the previous slide, that is the fatty acids containing the terminal carbon containing the methyl group. So this methyl group is counting as a omega 1 omega 2 omega 3, where the double bond is appears first. So that means the double bond is where the present between the carbons, that is omega 1 omega 2 omega 3. If the carbon bond, if the double bond is present between the 3 and 4, hence it is known as a omega 3. So where the double bond is first appears. See here it is the counting start from the terminal end of the carbon, that is the methyl end of the carbon. See here it is the omega 1 omega 2 omega 3. So the omega 3, that means double bond present between the omega 3 carbon and omega 4 carbon. So hence it is known as an omega 3 carbon. Now see the another example, omega 6. So here is the counting start with the omega 1 omega 2 carbon, omega 3 carbon, omega 4 carbon, omega 5 carbon, 1 2 3 4 omega 5 carbon. So here it is omega 6 carbon. So omega 1 carbon, omega 2 carbon, omega 3 carbon, omega 4 carbon, omega 5 carbon and omega 6 carbon. So the double bond starts between the present between the omega 6 and omega 7. Omega 6 and omega 7. Hence it is known as a omega 6 fatty acids. So maybe fatty acid containing two or more double bonds, whatever it may be, that where the first double bond is present between the, then you have to give the numbering, that is maybe is omega 3, omega 6 or omega 9. Now see the classification of the fatty acids. The classification of the fatty acids is saturated and unsaturated fatty acids. Classified into saturated fatty acids and unsaturated fatty acids. The saturated fatty acids does not contain the double bonds. Hence it is known as a saturated fatty acid. So the absence of double bonds. Saturated fatty acids, that is absence of double bonds. Unsaturated fatty acids, unsaturated. So due to the presence of double bonds, it is an unsaturated fatty acids. Unsaturated fatty acids containing the double bonds. These unsaturated fatty acids again divided into monounsaturated fatty acids and polyunsaturated fatty acids. The monounsaturated fatty acids, the meaning itself indicates mono means single. If the single double bond present in the unsaturated fatty acids, known as a monounsaturated fatty acid. If the double bond is single double bond containing the unsaturated fatty acids, known as the monounsaturated fatty acids. If the two or more double bond containing the unsaturated fatty acids, known as the polyunsaturated fatty acids. The poly is many. So the polyunsaturated fatty acid containing the two or more double bonds. See here it is the double bonds. Two or more double bonds. When the unsaturated fatty acids containing the two or more double bonds is known as a polyunsaturated fatty acid. If the double bond containing the unsaturated fatty acid, single double bond containing the unsaturated fatty acids called the monounsaturated fatty acids. Now see the saturated and unsaturated fatty acids. The saturated fatty acid do not contain the double bonds. See the example, acetic acid, propionic acid, butyric acid, caprylic acid, palmitic acid and stearic acid. Animal foods containing the saturated fatty acids: meat, butter, cheese, and egg yolk containing the saturated fatty acids. Plant foods also containing the saturated fatty acids. Example: coconut oil, palm oil, and cocoa butter. So these are containing the saturated fatty acids. So there is no need to buy at the example for the saturated fatty acids. You can remember in alphabetically, that is A, B, C. So instead of six, you can remember only three. So that is A, B, C. That is A means is acetic acid, B means is butyric acid, C means is caprylic acid. So you can remember easily in the way of is alphabetically A, B, C. A means is acetic acid, B means is butyric acid, C means is caprylic acid. These are the examples for the saturated fatty acids. So this again, saturated fatty acids are divided into lower fatty acids and higher fatty acids. Lower fatty acids containing the only 10 carbons or less carbons. 10 or less carbons. So saturated fatty acids containing the 10 or less carbons. So known as the lower fatty acids. Example of this lower fatty acids: acetic acid, milk, and butyric acid. Acetic acid, milk, and butyric acid. So milk contains the significant amount of lower fatty acid. Lower fatty acids. If the saturated fatty acids containing the more than 10 carbons is known as the higher fatty acids. Example: palmitic acid and stearic acid. So saturated fatty acids again divided into lower fatty acids and unsaturated fatty acids. Sorry, higher fatty acids. Now see the unsaturated fatty acids. These unsaturated fatty acids containing the one or more double bonds. If the one double bond containing the unsaturated fatty acids known as a monounsaturated fatty acids. Example: oleic acid. So oleic acid, see the formula 18:1:9. What is indicates this 18:1:9? 18 means is a oleic acid containing the 18 carbons. 1 means here it is a it's containing the one double bond. See here it is monounsaturated. That means it's containing only one double bond. So here it is the one means is a one double bond. 9 means here it is the double bond present between the 9 and 10 carbons. The double bond present between the 9 and 10 carbons. This is the formula. So oleic acid containing the 18 carbons, one double bond. The one double bond is present between the 9 and 10 carbons. So another example is butter. So one example is oleic acid. Another example is butter. So butter is increase the, see the function of the butter, increase the appetite, and also it's containing the above 72% of the monounsaturated fatty acids. Butter rich with the monounsaturated fatty acids, that is about 72%, and also nourish the body tissues and increase the body energy levels and increase the complexion of skin and strength of the body. Increase the complexion of the skin and strength of the body. Now see the unsaturated fatty acids containing the two or more double bonds is known as the polyunsaturated fatty acid. That is in the PUFA. PUFA means is polyunsaturated fatty acids. Example: linoleic acid. See here it is a linoleic acid, linolenic acid, and arachidonic acid. Linoleic acid, linoleic acid, and arachidonic acid. These are the example for the polyunsaturated fatty acid. See here it is the linoleic acid containing the 18 carbons and two double bonds. The two double bonds are present between the 9 and 10 carbons. Another double bond present between the 12 and 13 carbons. Present between the 9 and 10, another double bond present between the 12 and 13. Now see the dietary sources of the linoleic acid. The main sources of the linoleic acid that is present in the peanut oil, corn oil, cotton seed oil, soya bean oil, and egg yolk. Linoleic acid. The linoleic acid containing the three double bonds. Linoleic acid containing the two double bonds. Linoleic acid containing the three double bonds. The three double bonds are present between the 9 and 10 carbon, 12 and 13 carbon, 15 and 16 carbon. So the first one present between the 9 and 10, second one double bond present between 12 and 13. So 15th carbon contains third double bond, that is between the 15 and 16. So the dietary sources of the linoleic acid. So linoleic acid. This linoleic acid frequently presented in the linseed oil, rapeseed oil, soya bean oil, and cod liver oil. Linseed oil, rapeseed oil, and cod liver oil, and another one is soya bean oil. Now see the another example, arachidonic acid. So this containing the four double bonds. So already I told you polyunsaturated. So it's containing the two or more double bonds. Here it is the linoleic acid, two double bonds, and linoleic acid contain three double bonds. Arachidonic acid contain the four double bonds. These are the examples that fulfill with the polyunsaturated fatty acids. Okay. So arachidonic acid contain the four double bonds. These four double bonds present between the 5 and 6, 8 and 9, 11 and 12, 14 and 15. The main sources of the arachidonic acid is, that is, these are associated with the linoleic acid and linoleic acid with the small quantities, but particularly present in the peanut oil. So again, these unsaturated polyunsaturated fatty acids again divided into omega 3 fatty acids, omega 6 fatty acids, and omega 9 fatty acids. See here it is once again. The unsaturated fatty acids are divided into, classified into monounsaturated fatty acids and polyunsaturated fatty acids. The polyunsaturated fatty acids again divided into omega 3, omega 6, and omega 9 fatty acids. Say omega 9. So omega 6 and omega 3 are essential polyunsaturated fatty acids. Don't forget, omega 6 and omega 3 are essential polyunsaturated fatty acids. So oleic acid is the most excellent sources for the omega 3 essential fatty acid. Omega 3 essential fatty acid. And walnuts also contain the omega 3 rich fatty acid. Walnut is an example for the omega 3 rich fatty acid. When you consume the walnuts, it's lower the bad cholesterol, increase the good cholesterol. That means it increase the HDL cholesterol, decrease the LDL cholesterol when you consume the walnuts. Now see the, these are the 10 plant foods that is omega rich, omega 3 rich. So here it is a leafy greens, and so winter squash, beans, brassica vegetables, flax seeds, edamame, chia seeds, black walnuts, berries, and hemp seeds are containing the omega 3 rich fatty acids. These are the omega 3 rich fatty acids. Now see the essential fatty acids are the polyunsaturated. So example for the essential fatty acids are the polyunsaturated fatty acids. So omega 6 and omega 3 are the essential polyunsaturated fatty acids. Omega 6 fatty acids example linoleic acid and gamma linoleic acid and arachidonic acid. These arachidonic acid, gamma linoleic acid are the derivatives of the linoleic acid. These two are the, that is GLA and AA, is it? Derivatives of the linoleic acid. Omega 3 fatty acids, example is alpha linolenic acid. So eicosapentaenoic acid and docosahexaenoic acid, EPA and DHA, these are derivatives of ALA, that is alpha linolenic acid. So EPA and DHA, the derivatives of ALA. Omega 9 are non-essential polyunsaturated fatty acids. So omega 3, omega 6 are polyunsaturated, that is essential polyunsaturated fatty acids. The omega 9 is a non-essential polyunsaturated fatty acid. Now see the main sources for the essential fatty acids, that is GLA and LA, that is linoleic acid, gamma linoleic acid, arachidonic acid, and EPA and DHA. EPA means is eicosapentaenoic acid, and DHA means docosahexaenoic acid. These are the main sources for the essential fatty acids. Essential fatty acids. So now see the linoleic acid, essential fatty acid. See the content of different foods, different vegetables and vegetable oils. The linoleic acid is present in the, mainly available in the vegetable oils and vegetables, that is sunflower containing the 65 to 75% of the linoleic acid, evening primrose oil containing the 72%, corn containing the 57%, peanut containing the 31%, canola contain the 19 to 26% of the linoleic acid, and olive contain the only 8% of the linoleic acid. Another is the gamma linoleic acid. The gamma linoleic acid is a excellent source, that is a borage oil. Borage oil, star flower oil. This is a star flower oil. Star flower oil containing the about 20 to 24% of the gamma linoleic acid. Evening primrose containing the 8 to 10% only. But evening primrose containing the linoleic acid is more, that is about 72%. And black currant containing the 15 to 17% of the GLA. So GLA also present in human breast milk, that is very little amount. That is very little amount. Arachidonic acid is a high amount that is present in the eggs, fish, and meat. So meat, fish, and eggs containing a high amount of arachidonic acid. Eicosapentaenoic acid and hexonic acid. So these two are found in mainly fatty fish like is salmonella and tuna. The salmonella and tuna containing the EPA and DHA. So depends upon the availability of the fish oils, the EPA and DHA sources are vary. That is, fish oil supplements containing the 18% EPA and 12% of DHA. The concentrated oils containing the EPA is about 30%, DHA contains about 20%. EPA means is eicosapentaenoic acid, DHA is docosahexaenoic acid. The concentrated oils containing the about 30% of the eicosapentaenoic acid, 20% of the docosahexaenoic acid. Now see the essential fatty acids in the treatment and prevention of diseases. The uses of the essential fatty acids in the treatment and prevention of diseases. The deficiency of the essential fatty acids mainly observed in mental disorders, diabetes, atherosclerosis, hypertension, eczema, and immune dysfunctions, and also rheumatoid arthritis. That is nothing but is inflammatory conditions. So the inflammatory conditions such as rheumatoid arthritis. The eicosapentaenoic acid and docosahexaenoic acid helps to maintain the healthy heart and protect the against the heart diseases by the way of reducing the high blood lipids and reducing the blood pressure and decreasing the blood clottings. So EPA and DHA is involved in the reducing the high blood lipids and high blood pressure and decreasing the blood clotting and increasing the, so maintain the healthy heart and protect the against the heart diseases. So during the pregnancy, DHA supplementation may reduce the risk of early premature birth. And very low birth weight, that is less than 1.5 kg baby. So 1.5 kg. So DHA also important for the visual and neurological development. So this is important for the DHA is important for the visual and neurological development and reduces the risk of early premature birth and very low birth weight. The main important function of the GLA is it is converted to eicosanoids. So eicosanoids, the main property of the eicosanoids is the anti-inflammatory property. It shows the anti-inflammatory property and modulates the immune response and also decrease the joint inflammation and destruction. And also many rheumatoid arthritis suffers the deficiency of GLA, and these people are respond to the GLA treatment. The rheumatoid arthritis people respond to the GLA treatment. The deficiency of the eicosapentaenoic essentially fatty acids that is related to the eczema and other skin disorders. So GLA is also involved in the eczema. The deficiency of the GLA involved in the eczema and other skin disorders. The essential fatty acids also reduce the moisture loss. The most important of the GLA here it is a decrease the joint inflammation and destruction. That is the advantage of the GLA, and also decrease the skin disorders also. Now see the omega-3 essentially fatty acids. The omega-3 essentially fatty acids play the role in depression, bipolar disorders, Alzheimer's, dementia, consecutive impairment, and behavioral learning disorders. learning disorders. Now see the diet and their recommended daily. So dietary allowances per daily, that is linoleic acid required about is 4.44 grams. That is alpha linoleic acid required is about 2.22 grams per daily. So both DHA and EPA required for the about 0.65 grams per daily. See the side effects, that is essential fatty acid supplementations. So there is no serious side effects if you consume the less than 50 grams. That's maybe is a minor side effects containing about more than, if you consume the more than 50 grams of essential fatty acids. So that is burping, flatulency, soft stools and diarrhea. If you consume more than 50 grams of essential fatty acids, you can get the minor side effects, that is burping, flatulency, soft stools and diarrhea. Now see here it is up to, that is the classification as these unsaturated fatty acids, saturated and unsaturated fatty acids. The saturated unsaturated fatty acids again divided into polyunsaturated fatty acids and monounsaturated fatty acids. The examples of the polyunsaturated fatty acids are linoleic acid, linoleic acid, arachidonic acid and DHA and EPA. So eicosapentaenoic acid and docosahexaenoic acid. These are the example for the unsaturated folic acid and also known as essential unsaturated folic acid. So omega 6, omega 3 and omega 9 also comes under the unsaturated folic acids. So the unsaturated, that is a pupa. See now the trans fatty acids. What are the trans fatty acids? These are the unhealthy substances. We can get these trans fatty acids from the vegetable oils, the hydrogenation of vegetable oils. So we can get the trans fats from the hydrogenation of the vegetable oils. These are unhealthy substances. These trans fatty acids naturally found in the animal products like this meat, whole milk and milk products. Not only the found in meat, whole milk and milk products, and also found in cakes, cookies, crackers, icing, margarines and microwave popcorns. See the disadvantages of the trans fats. That main disadvantage, increase the LDL cholesterol and decrease the HDL cholesterol. Increase the bad cholesterol, decrease the good cholesterol. So avoid the consumption of trans fats. Now see the different contents of fats present in different products. That is coconut oil containing the above 92% of the saturated fatty acids, 6% about the monounsaturated fatty acids and 2% is polyunsaturated fatty acids. Palm oil containing the 46% of saturated fatty acid, 44% of the monounsaturated fatty acid, polyunsaturated pupa containing the about 10%. Cotton seed oil containing the 25% of saturated fatty acid, that is SF, and 25% is monounsaturated content, that is mono, MUFA. The called is MUFA means is monounsaturated fatty acids and 50% is PUFA. So groundnut oil containing about the 19% of SA, that is saturated fatty acids, 50% is here it is MUFA and 31% is PUFA. Sunflower oil containing the SA 10%, 15% is MUFA, 75% is PUFA. Sunflower oil containing the about is 8% is SA, 27% is MUFA. MUFA means is monounsaturated fatty acids. So, and 65% is PUFA. Corn oil containing the about 8% of the SA, 27% is MUFA, 65% is PUFA. Soybean oil containing the 14% is SA, 24% of the MUFA and 62% is PUFA. Butter containing the 60% is SA, 37% is MUFA and 3% is PUFA. Polyunsaturated fatty acids. So butter, out of these two, see here it is butter containing the saturated fatty acids about 60%, but here is the least in polyunsaturated fatty acid. So should avoid the butter consumption. Now see the advantages of the essential fatty acids. Essential fatty acids also is a special type of good fat, and sometimes it is called as a vitamin A. Vitamin F. Essential fatty acids are required for the proper membrane structure, maintain the proper membrane structure and transport of the cholesterol, formation of lipoproteins, prevention of fatty liver, and need for the synthesis of eicosanoids. So it's mainly required for the essential fat is required for the transport of cholesterol, formation of lipoproteins, prevention of fatty livers, and need for the synthesis of eicosanoids. So increase the essentially fatty acids or increase the absorption of vitamins and minerals, especially vitamins are fat soluble vitamins, so that is A, D, E, K, and nourish the skin and nourish the hair and nails and promote the proper nerve functioning, help to produce the hormones and ensure the normal growth and development. So the linoleic acid, that is omega-6 fatty acid, and alpha-linoleic acid, that is ALA, omega-3 fatty acid, that's considered the essential fatty acid, essential polyunsaturated fatty acids. So because they cannot be synthesized by humans. Both the omega-6 and omega-3 fatty acids are important, the structural components of the cell membranes and serve as a precursors to bioactive lipid mediators and provide the source of energy. When you replace the saturated fatty acids with the omega-6, it lowers the total bad cholesterol. So when replacing the saturated fatty acids with omega-6, it lowers the total bad cholesterol, and increasing the EPA and DHA intake, the benefit the individuals with the type 2 diabetes mellitus. If you consumption of more EPA and DHA, then reduce the type 2 diabetes mellitus. Now see the dietary sources of lipids. The main sources of the lipids are milk, egg yolk, fish oil, and meat. So both the visible and invisible sources must be taken into account by calculating the fat content of a meal. So dietary sources of lipids, the many sources may be hidden or invisible. So, but here it is the main sources are milk, egg yolk, fish oil, and meat. The plant sources, the lipids content, sorry, here it is lipid sources, plant sources containing the lipids, that is groundnut, sesame, soya bean, rice bran oil, coconut oil, almond, cashew nut, and corn, sunflower oil, all are hydrogenated fats, and maraginine, they are the sources of lipids. So these are the sources of the lipids. So plant sources containing the lipids, that is groundnut oil, sesame oil, soya bean oil, rice bran oil, coconut oil, almond oil containing the oil and fats, that is plant sources. These are the plant sources. Animal sources of the fat and oils. Mutton, pork, fish, poultry, milk and milk products, such as the milk products as butter, cream, yogurt, cheese, eggs and organ meats. These are the animal sources of fat and oils. Invisible sources. The invisible sources are mainly salad dressing, flesh foods, dessert, cookies, cakes, milk and eggs, milk-based sweets. Example is, these are all examples for the invisible sources of fat and oils. So which are rich in fat and, but the fat is not visible. But fat is not visible. Now see the main functions of the lipids. They provide the energy, absorb the vitamins, maintain the proper body temperature, and maintain the healthy hair and skin. And also main sources for the energy our body is carbohydrates. The main sources of the energy is the carbohydrates. When the carbohydrates energy is absent, the fat is usually as a source of backup energy. Backup energy. Each gram of fat, so give the 9 calories. So when you consume the 1 gram of fat, you can get the 9 calories from the 1 gram of fat. So avoid the consumption of fat about more than 20 to 35%. Now see the absorption of the vitamins. Absorption of the vitamins. Certain vitamins, the lipid, the main function of the lipid is absorption of the vitamins, that is especially is a fat soluble vitamins, vitamin A, D, E, and K. The individual vitamins, see the functions of the individual vitamins. The vitamin E is responsible for the promoting the good vision and keeping of our eyes healthy. The vitamin E, D is helps to absorb the calcium. Vitamin E neutralizes the free radicals. Vitamin K is essential for blood clotting. If you don't have the enough fat, your body you may become deficient in one or more these vitamins. Now see the deficiency of the fats. If the deficiency of the fats, poor body temperature regulation, dryness of the skin may lead to the fat soluble vitamin deficiency, loss of menstrual cycle, extreme mental fatigue. So due to the deficiency of the fats, dryness of the skin may lead to the fat soluble vitamin deficiency, loss of menstrual cycle, extreme mental fatigue and poor body temperature regulation. If you consume excessive fats, cause obesity, excess of fat stored in adipose tissue, atherosclerosis, constipation and cardiovascular diseases. If you consume more fat or otherwise excessive intake, it leads to the obesity. Excess fat is stored in adipose tissue, atherosclerosis, constipation and cardiovascular diseases. Now see the RDA, recommended dietary allowance. Fat should be not contribute more than 30% kilocalories. Saturated food, saturated fat should be is not more than 10%. Now see the recommended dietary requirement for MUFA, that is monounsaturated fatty acids. Replacing carbohydrates with MUFA, that increases the HDL cholesterol concentration. So when you replacing the carbohydrates with the MUFA, monounsaturated fatty acids, that increases the HDL cholesterol. So replacing the SFA, that's been saturated fatty acids, with MUFA reduces the LDL cholesterol concentration. If you replace the SFA with MUFA, reduce the LDL cholesterol concentration. If you replace the carbohydrates with MUFA, improves the insulin sensitivity. So altogether, MUFA increases the HDL cholesterol and reduces the LDL cholesterol, improves the insulin sensitivity. Now see the recommended dietary requirements for PUFA, that is polyunsaturated fatty acids. When replacing the SFA with PUFA, saturated fatty acids with PUFA, decreasing the risk of CHD. So PUFA affect the risk of alternations and related to the metabolic syndrome. So when you intake of PUFA is increased, that reduces the risk of diabetes. Now see the tips to consume healthy forms of fat. Choose whole grain starches, fresh whole fruits and vegetables. Consume variety of colorful fruits, vegetables, grains from the week to week. Limit the refined starches and added sugars. So because the starches and added sugars are less nutrient, contain the less nutrients and promotes the inflammatory symptoms such as weight gain and elevated blood glucose levels and lipid levels. Choose skinless poultry, fish, eggs and legumes and fat-free Greek yogurt. Choose monounsaturated and omega-3 fats which are rich thought to neutralize the inflammation. And choose omega-3 fatty acids can decrease the inflammation associated with the exercise. Limit the saturated fat, that should be avoid the saturated fat and avoid the trans fat. So because of the, it decreases the good cholesterol and increases the bad cholesterol. So write the answer regarding about the what are the trans advantages and disadvantages of saturated, unsaturated and trans fatty acid. Then you have to give the classification of the fatty acids, that is saturated fatty acids and unsaturated fatty acids. The unsaturated fatty acids containing the double bonds, that maybe is more or two double bond, more double bonds. So if the one double bond containing known as a monounsaturated fatty acids, if the double bond containing two or more is known as a polyunsaturated fatty acids. This polyunsaturated fatty acids again give the again classified into omega 3, omega 6, and omega 9 is like that. Then you have to give the example for the monounsaturated fatty acid, that is linoleic acid, linoleic acid, and arachidonic acid, eicosapentaenoic acid, and docosahexaenoic acid. These are the example for the polyunsaturated fatty acid. Give the advantages of the essential fatty acid, that is nothing but is a polyunsaturated fatty acids. So regarding this omega 6, omega three fatty acids. That means is a linoleic acid, arachidonic acid. So the advantage of the arachidonic acid, advantage of the linoleic acid, and advantage of the linoleic acid, and advantage of the eicosapentaenoic acid, and advantage of the docosahexaenoic acid. And now we have to give the disadvantage. That means is nothing but is a deficiency of the essential fatty acids. So where you are observed the essential fatty acid deficiency, that is nothing but is a mental disorders, diabetes, atherosclerosis, hypertension, eczema, and bacterial fungus. So this is the way how to give the advantages and disadvantages. What are the trans fatty acids? The trans fatty acids occurs from the obtained from the that is hydrogenation of oils. So this is very trans fatty acids are unhealthy. So it decreases the good cholesterol but increases the bad cholesterol. Okay. So now give the again diet recommended dietary values. So that is nothing but is how much content is required. That is linoleic acid. That means is nothing but is unsaturated fatty acids. So polyunsaturated fatty acids. Linoleic acid required for about is 4.44 grams per daily. Sala required for the about 2.22 grams per daily. And DHA EPA required for about the 0.65 grams is daily. Okay. If a side effects, if you consume the more amount of essential fatty acids, more than 50 grams. You can get these minor side effects. That is nothing but is a burping, flatulency, soft stools, and diarrhea. Okay. So, eat healthy and stay healthy. Thank you.